Hey Team Mopeg. So today starts our first day of teaching new math to you guys. What's great about this unit is that it builds upon this is Unit 5. It builds upon the things that you've already learned. All right. So today, what we're doing is we're focusing on recognizing multiples and non-multiples of three. So multiples of three, which we already learned previously, and other numbers that are not multiples of three. And also writing equations that show how a number is a multiple of three. So with that being said, I want to explain that how this is laid out, this page, and also do like a little mini lesson with you that will hopefully help you when you go to do your work. So for example, the first thing is that you will be doing your independent math warm-up. 10 minutes, you just do either extra math or you can practice skip counting. If you click on this practice skip counting link, it will give you a whole bunch of ideas for skip counting on about like certain numbers. All right, second thing you need to do is that you need to watch the video lessons for the MWIs. So you can watch these either through Google Classroom or on EasyBridge. And up here, Miss Callie put up a tutorial for how to get onto EasyBridge. Remember, we always go to our waffle, go down there. Okay. Then on our Moped Google Classroom, there is going to be a video, this video, in which you will go ahead and you will be getting your lesson from Miss Molly or I or another third grade teacher. After you watch that video, you're then gonna go into the independent practice. All right. So independent practice will be to it's obviously you have already watched this video. All right. You're gonna use the cubes train slides to help you. All right. And those will be located on the Moped Google Classroom. Then you're gonna complete activity books. Page 279 and 280, that's in your math book. It's not anything that we've already torn out, so it should already be in there. Okay. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna put the answers into the forms on the math and the Moped Math Google Classroom. And they're titled by the page number. All right. So that Miss Molly and I can be looking at your work and checking it. And then the last part is that you're gonna do exact path math. You're gonna complete one column, lesson, practice, quiz. All right? So let's get into our lesson for today. All right, guys. So up here we have a three cube train. All right? We're gonna be working over the next few sessions on cube trains. All right? So cube trains will have like something that's repeating over and over again. Or a segment of some sort that is going to repeat over and over again. All right. And that's going to help us to think about multiplication and division. So I already went ahead and I numbered these cubes. So this red one is cube number one, blue two, green three, red four, blue five, six green, seven red, eight blue. Nine green, red 10, 11 blue, 12 green. Right? So, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be looking at the color pattern and predicting what color certain number cubes are. All right, so let's think about this. When we look at this cube train, what are we seeing? What are you seeing in this cube train and how would you describe it? So, if you want right now, you can pause this video and you can have a discussion with yourself or with a family member. All right, so when we look at this cube train, we're seeing that this cube train is constructed as groups of three. So right here, the group of three, and each of these cube train is red, blue, green, red, blue, green, red, blue, green, red, blue, green, right? So it's a segment of three. you guys see that? Segment of three. Oh, I just messed that up. Of course I did. Just like we're in class, right, guys? All right, so let me put this back up here. Nope. This Pago's messing it up again. All right, let me get that back up. All right, good. So a red, blue, green pattern in segments of three. All right, so when I think to myself, I think about the segments, and I think that there's three, and they're repeating. So I can think of it as a 1-2-3 pattern, right? So 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-2-3. Or I can even think of it as A-B-C, 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 all right? Okay, sometimes like I like to do move. You know how I'm all about movements, right? So I could do like A-B-C, A-B-C, A, B, C. Okay, and that keeps going. All right, good job. So now we want to make sure that we're seeing a connection between the cube patterns, right, and numbers and counting numbers, right? So we know that, again, that the first cube is red. What color is the second cube? The second cube is blue, right? What is the color of the sixth cube? I want you to pause this video and think about what is the color of the sixth cube. Go ahead and pause it. All right, the color of the sixth cube is green. Good. I want you to pause this and answer the question of what is color is the eighth cube. Go ahead. All right, the eighth cube is blue. Imagine that this pattern goes on the same way past the cubes I'm holding. What color would the next cube be? What would cube number 13 be? What color would cube number 13 be? I want you to pause this video and answer that question. Good job. If you said red, the next cube number 13 would be red. Excellent. Good. What about cube number 15? What would cube number 15 be? And how do you know? All right, pause the video. All right, if you said that cube number 15 would be green, then you are golden. How do we know? Well, here I am. I know that number 15 is a multiple of 3. And here we have 3, 6, 9, 12. Next multiple would be 15, and they are all green cubes. All right, good job. So that is what we're going to be working on today as a class, all right? So when I go to page 279, all right, I'm going to read it to you guys. It says, build a train of 12 cubes with these colors in this order. Red, blue, green, red, blue, green, red, blue, green, red, blue, green. Now, this is where these slides come in, all right? Before we even get to that, here is the slide deck, okay? So before we even get to page 279, I'm going to stop for a minute. It says cube train. Cube trains are a great way to notice patterns and learn multiplication facts. These slides, not this video, not the one that Mrs. Pagos is doing, but these slides will be used when you go to do page 279 all the way to 299. Listen, you're not doing all those pages today. All you're doing today is 270 and 280. That is it. Do you guys understand that? But this slide, you can always come back to these slides to help you. So it says, exploring multiplication. A group has more than one thing. Equal groups mean the same as. Equal group are groups that have the same number in them. So a group of three, right, is the number of people in this group, equal group, and the number of people in this group is a group of three. When we go here, it says exploring multiplication. add equal groups to find the sum, right? So like repeated addition, right? Like right here, 2 plus 2 plus 2 equals 6. Or you can even multiply equal groups to find the product. These are strategies that you can use for multiplication, all right? So 3 equal groups of 2, 3 times 2 equals 6. That's the number of groups. 3 is the number of groups. 2 is the number in each group, and the product is 6. So 3 times 2 is 6 is a multiplication sentence, all right? So exploring multiplication. All right, so there are 10 cubes in each cube train. How many cubes are in 5 train? All right, so you can also skip count. So repeated addition, multiplication, or even skip counting, right? So if this is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Good. All right, so now I messed up here. So let's go back to page 379. So it says that we need to build. So this is where you're going to use the manipulatives here. We don't have cubes in front of us, right? We didn't go home with them. So we created this slide. Miss Callie created this slide so that you're able to make whatever the direction is telling you. So this one is telling you to build a train of 12 cubes with these colors in this order. Red, blue, green, red, blue, green, red, blue, green, red, blue, green. So what you're going to do, you're going to click on it, and you can either go to edit, copy, edit, paste, and then you're going to start building that train. So it told me I needed 12 cubes. So this is right now 3, 6. Again, you can either right click and do copy, and then right click, paste. Okay. So now I have 3, 6, 9, or I can go back up here, edit, copy, edit, paste. All right. And then let's double check to make sure this is 12. 3, 6, 9, 12. Okay. So right there, we built the 12 cubes that they wanted. So now I'm able to answer the questions that go along on page 279. So it's going to say, if this pattern keeps repeating its same color, what color is the 13th cube? Now, we don't have the 13th cube. You can either continue to build on using this manipulative, or you can use what you already know about the pattern that's occurring here, all right? But this is what's really important. When I go to my Mopeg Math Google Classroom, I know I'm on workbook page 279. I'm going to open it up. And I need to, it says number one, what is the color of the 13th cube? That is number one here. We don't have, it doesn't say number one, but we're going to go in order, okay? And then you're going to answer, you're going to do the work in your notebook, in your workbook, but you're also going to put your answers here, okay? Because we want to see it and see how you're doing with it, okay? So now one more thing. So that's how you're going to be doing using this for the cube train. All right. Are there any questions about that? If there are, you can always reach out to Miss Molly and I. So then the next part is going to be adding and subtracting multiples of 10 and 100. So that's page 280. So I want you to understand, we are not going any further in this slide deck for today's lesson. Okay. So we're only going up to slide 5 and then stopping. Slide 6, 7, 8, and so on are all for the next couple of lessons, okay? Does everybody understand that? All right, so let's go back to adding and subtracting multiples of 10 and 100, all right? So this problem number one has 3 parts. Sorry, it's really hard. 1, 2, 3. I did 1A, 1B, 1C. So when I go, I'm going to do my work on this. And then I'm going to go to day 11, all right? And I'm going to click page 280, because that's the page. And then I'm going to type in my answer here, all right? I just type it in. And then when I'm all done, I'm going to submit it. So again, this is 1A, 1B, 1C. All right, so that is the end of today's lesson. So today we built cube trains with multiples of 3, and we analyzed and looked for patterns within our cubes. So if you guys have any questions, Ms. Moley and I are here. We're happy to help, but you guys got this. So make sure, I just want you to make sure that you submit these pages for us to be able to see. All right, go get them, Tigers. Bye.